Welcome to another episode of Core Top 10s. I'm Legacy.
And I'm Max.
Vitamin J.
All right. So today we're doing another great episode of Top 10s. We are actually going to be doing Top 10 animated songs, movie songs. All right. So the deal is we did have, has to be an animated movie, but we also put a stipulation that a character had to have sung it. It can't be just noise in the background or noise affiliated with it. Case in point, if you think about Lion King, so Circle of Life would not count because it's not sung by any of the characters, but you could do I Just Can't Wait to Be King because the characters do sing that song. Those are the rules we stood by. As you know, everybody gave me a list. Two people aren't here. D3 and the Mountain aren't here. Who knows where they are, but
they might pop forever. In.
They'll pop in sometimes because we got stuff to do. All right, if you haven't seen it before, everybody sends me a list of their top 10. One gets 10 points. Number 10 gets 1 point. Figure it out from there. And then I add and calculate them all together. Top 10 of that gets into the songs. Now, today we had a total of 34 songs, and right there, D3 pops in. And no song got every person.
I don't think any song
got more than three people, actually. Got more than three people. Yeah, guys, you're going to be surprised. There was some diversity with these songs, and some that we're going to be surprised that did or didn't make it.
All
right. Gentlemen, are you ready?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, coming in at number 10 with 10 points, it is from probably going to be one of the few that's on here that is not from a Disney movie. Keyword, a lot of this was dominated by Disney movies.
Actually.
But we had everybody had a couple that were not Disney movies. Unfortunately, the person isn't even here. It was the Mountain's number one. It was from the SpongeBob movie, Goofy Goober.
See what the scallop?
I'm a Goofy Goober! You're a Goofy Goober! We're all Goofy Goobers! Put your toy.
That's that number one.
That was his number one.
He's memeing. That was his number one. He's memeing. He's trying.
Yeah.
I mean, even if it wasn't, it's just what he gave me a list, and that was at the top, so I figured that's that was funny. The one.
He'll never watch this either. But what a terrible number one, I tell you. It's not a bad song, but number one. I mean, come on, there's a lot of songs better than that.
It's not number one material.
No.
I've never watched it, so I don't know.
Well, yeah, we know you.
Of course, you haven't, because you don't have taste.
Yeah, you're a hater. You're not a goofy. You're not a goofy goober. No, you're not Goofy Goober material.
No, it's a good song. It's a good way to end the movie. Just number one.
Yeah, it's a bit ripped from my blood.
Part of me was like, is it really that good? Because, I mean, I just know it's I'm a Goofy Goober. It's like the only lyric I know. But
it's like a rock song at the end.
It's fun. Like,
have you heard the song, the Twisted Sister song, I Wanna Rock?
Yeah.
It's pretty much that Goofy Goober version of that.
It's not bad, but, you know.
I mean, if only he was here to explain himself, you know.
Well, drugs is the only answer. I like SpongeBob, but just not number one.
That's not even the best SpongeBob song, I mean.
Not even close. I mean, Jacob's the biggest SpongeBob fan here.
He's like, no, not top 10, sir. Not top 10.
No, I didn't have it in my top 10, but I do like the song.
I mean, it's been a few times where I hear something in the top 10, I'm disgusted that it's on the list. I mean, he's insulting us right now. He's pretty much making a mockery of this podcast.
He must have spent 2 seconds on this list. we got to have something better for number 9. We got to have something better.
Yep. All right. So number 9, coming up with one more point, but a lot better song. Two people voted for this. It was my number 9. It was Vitamin J's number 2. It is I Just Can't Wait to Be King. Lion King.
I'm gonna be a mighty king, so enemies beware. I'm brushing up, I'm looking down, I'm working on my roar. Oh, I just can't wait to be king. Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
Much better selection, a much better selection. I give y'all kudos.
Oh yeah, this is
Lion King. It's a good song.
It's a really good song. Let me let Vitamin J, because he put it second.
It's just a nice, you know, nice little ditty, you know? It's a nice beat. It makes you, as a kid, you feel happy watching it, you know?
only be crushed like 10 minutes later.
Yeah. Well, you know.
Disney just lulls you in with a nice catchy song, just and then to punch you in the face with Mufasa's death.
They start you off with a banger, you know, Circle of Life, boom. And then you got, a little bit later, you got, you know, Just Can't Wait to Be King. So it starts off on two good notes.
I like this song. I think I just like also the fun with this song. There's a lot. I think even him and the several parts you can sing. I just like the kind of back and forth with the parts with like every character and even the background. I think it's just like, you know, cool song to drive to. You know, a lot of mine is like, how much do I want to sing about it later, and how much the re-singability.
And I'll say the animation during that song is very catchy, very colorful. Poor Zazu's holding all the animals at the end. Poor guy.
Yeah, let's go to our next song. Our number 8, it was voted on 5th by The Mountain and Vitamin J with 12 points. It is a classic song that's sung on a magic carpet ride. It is A Whole New World from Aladdin.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew. But when I'm way up here, it's crystal clear.
Now I'm in a whole new world.
I mean, there's a banger. It just didn't make my top 10, but it's a banger. I ain't disputing that banger.
It's like, I put it on the list because I was like, when we first started this list, I was like, huh, I wonder, I was like, let me think of the best like song someone sung, and one of the first ones was Whole New World, so.
It's probably one of the best duet songs they have out of all of these.
Which part do you sing more, Jasmine or Aladdin?
Obviously Jasmine, I mean, come on.
She does got the best part, though.
So I try to do one per movie, except for one movie. I made an exception for one movie.
I got a different song from this movie on my list.
So do I.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, I do. A matter of fact, I do. Do you remember that video of the dude back in the day who did both the male and female parts? Yeah.
Yeah.
And no one to tell us no, nowhere to go, say we're only dreaming.
That's pretty crazy.
All right, we're going to go on to another song coming in with 16 points. There was actually a two-way tie for this. This is number 6, two-way tie. Songs with 16 points. We're going to go with this one first of Aladdin. We're going to another Aladdin song. It was voted on number 5 by Maps, number 6 by D3, and number 6 by The Mountain. It is sung by the genie from at the very beginning. Once you meet him, it is A Friend Like Me.
Can your friends do this? Can your friends do that? Can your friends pull this out their little hat? Can your friends go, woo! Hey, looky here.
I mean, it's Robin Williams. I mean, what more can you ask for?
Yeah, you said you liked the Lion King song, I Just Can't Wait to Be King, because it was fun. This is a fun song, because Robin Williams isn't exactly a great singer, okay? So the fact that they made a great song with him on it, that tells you how good of a song this is. And just like the fast pace of him talking and everything.
Yeah, honestly, this song really helps solidify this performance as one of the all-time greatest voice acting performances of all time. I mean, when we think of legendary celebrities doing voiceover work, this is like near the top of everybody's list.
Of course, because I just said, this is Robin freaking Williams.
I said, the genie is factually correct. Aladdin would never have a friend like the genie who can grant wishes. I mean, what more do you want? I did like how he showed off his powers during the song. It was pretty cool to see how powerful the genie is. And I feel I'll give Will Smith credit. He did his best with the newer version of the song, but it was just never compared to Robin Williams.
I mean, it's...
You got some power in your corner now. Heavy ammunition in your camp. You got some punch, pizzazz. Yes. And how? All you gotta do is rub that lamp. But then I'll say, Mr. Man, what's your name? Whatever, what will your pleasure be? Let me take your order, I'll jot it down. You ain't never had a friend like me.
It's just hard to beat a legendary performance.
Well, yeah, I feel bad for anyone that tries to top a legendary. It's like with the Joker, with Heath Ledger. Good luck trying to top it.
They did at least try to make it more Will Smith style, because they did make it more hip-hop in the live action.
They had to.
It was still solid.
It was still solid, but not as good as Robin Williams.
I will say there's a lot going on with the song, which is what makes it a lot cooler too.
I mean, we're Robin Williams. There's always a lot going on.
We'll move on. Other sixth place, also coming in with 16 points, is coming from the hit classic Mulan. I'll make a man out of you. Let's get down to business. To defeat the Huns. But you can bet before we're through, Mr. I'll make a man out of you. Oh man, I love it.
It's a great montage song. You see Mulan getting her butt whipped during the beginning, and then she becomes an actually capable soldier at the end.
I will say, like, with all these songs, and with this one, I think it just does a great job of progressing the story well.
Oh, it does.
Just keep going forward and forward of showing you, okay, we don't have time for her to like, take 20 minutes to get better. Right. We're just going to kind of progress.
It was an effective training montage, you know, like the good old 80 movies.
And look, I think it's Donny Osmond who sings the song, man. His voice is very, very, he has a very lovely singing voice.
And I like it. Each gives, like, each character like a little part to sing as well.
Oh, yeah, when those three characters sing. Yeah, I like that part, too.
Yeah.
I like it when you just straight slayed him in the beginning.
Like some people might find that blue.
He's like the saddest bunch I ever met. Jeez, God.
You haven't got a clue.
He's like, did they send me daughters when I asked for sons?
And he's like, well, actually, one of them dead.
Right.
One of them dead, actually. I think I also like she's part of like trying to help Mulan out, but kind of like getting Mulan caught.
They're getting her in trouble.
Yeah. So that's kind of really cool.
Fun fact, Jackie Chan sings the Cantonese version.
Does it sound good? Can he sing?
I think he's released albums and
yeah, I think China. He actually is a singer.
Okay.
Didn't see that one.
Okay. I think he's actually sold a decent amount of records.
Yeah, just YouTube it afterwards.
Yeah, I'm also gonna state this right now. Disney, what the hell? What was up with that?
Live
movie?
Action.
I
just gotta state this. Why are you gonna make a Mulan live action? No songs, no Mushu, no cricket. Like, why are you calling it Mulan? That's not Mulan. Also, we're gonna add this witch character that's gonna completely take away from the point of Mulan being the only female that's there fighting. But whatever.
They try to be like more traditional to the story, but like, no, you're just doing it based off your animated classics. Just keep it like the animated classic. I mean, that's what you're picking back off of. That's what people are expecting. If, like I said, non-Disney movie, that probably would have been fine, but no.
Don't call it Mulan.
I mean, that's the reason I still have not watched that one.
Murphy's still alive, so he can still do Mushu, because I really don't want to hear another voice with it.
It would be right.
I have the characters. Do the story I want to see. This has some of the best songs and very underrated.
I'll say, I got another Mulan song. There's a better Mulan song than this one.
There is not.
This one was second best.
It's not my top ten.
It might make the list. It might not. We'll see.
So what, Max? What y'all two just said is blasphemy. It's almost as bad as Hunt saying Goofy Goober is number one.
It's nowhere near as bad. It's nowhere near as bad as Goofy Goober number one.